Hello, good morning. My name is Odion Ikuga, and it's the 23rd day of September 2016. Such an incredible time to be alive. I'm very concerned about something that is very, very, very interesting, and I want to share with you a bit. You see, right about now, the leaders of the nations of the earth, they are gathered in the city of New York for the United Nations General Assembly. Leaders from all the countries of this world, they are deliberating on measures to bring peace, security, and lasting well-being to the earth. The world is replete with chaos, from the economic recession to the war in Syria, the war on terrorism to corruption in Nigeria. You see, it's perplexity of the nations, and it tends to bring the leaders of the world to their knees. You see, these men are gathered for a good reason, as it were. But allow me to tell you that much as they want to see a world that is peaceful, to see a world that there's love, to see a world that there's peace and security, these men, they are doing it the wrong way. Many people want to say, what does this young man know that he's talking about? They are doing it the wrong about them doing it the wrong way. Yeah, but that's true. There is no way you can find peace when you have not enthroned the Prince of Peace. Until the leaders of this world realize that Jesus was given for the governance of the nations of the world, I'm not sure they will ever find peace through all these deliberations that they are doing. Come to really consider what I'm saying. It's interesting. It is interesting. Jesus came for the governance of the nations. He is King of Kings. Apparently, he rules, he reigns. He alone has the right of rule over the peoples and the nations of this world. And until those men, those elite folks sitting in the United Nations General Assembly find this out and realize this and submit to this, the world that they feel that they are governing, that they are in charge of, the thing that will happen is that the world will fall to pieces and break upon with its weight upon them. It is as easy as that. You want to ask me, and I will tell you. On the day of the ascension of Jesus, the disciples assembled themselves based on what they have felt, what they have learned about God's plan to bring a king for the people of Israel. After Jesus came, he had died, he resurrected. He met with them and he was still talking about this kingdom. These people, they were bewildered so much that they came to ask Jesus. They said, Lord, are you at this time going to restore the kingdom of Israel? That was an interesting question, because right then, the people of Israel were under the occupation, or under the Roman occupation. The people of Israel, they had lost everything that they had known that was theirs, according to heritage. Rome, the city of Rome, pagan Rome as it were, had occupied the land. That was an interesting question. The core of the calling of Jesus was put to question. And how was Jesus' answer? What did he say? In fact, I will just read it. You see this book? This is the constitution of the government of God. I hope the United Nations General Assembly folks there, I hope they realize that this book was given for the governance of the nation. The Holy Bible, this book is given for the governance of the nations. It's not a religious book. It's not just a religious book. This is a political document. And I will show you something on the inside. If you look at Acts chapter 1 verse 6, From 6 to 8, Jesus replied, following the question they asked him, "The Father alone has the authority to set those dates and times. They are not for you to know. But you shall receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, and you will be my witnesses, telling people about me everywhere, in Jerusalem, throughout Judea, in Samaria, and to the ends of the earth." You see, Jesus gave the Holy Spirit here as a solution to a political problem. The Holy Spirit is given to man for the governance of man. The Holy Spirit is given to man to lead us, to direct us, to kick out the devil, to help us kick out the devil, uproot the plantings that the devil has planted as far as the governance of this world is concerned, and establish the reign of Jesus. That's it. That's what it is. The Holy Spirit was given as an answer to a political problem. The answer to the problems of this world is in the person of the Holy Spirit. The person of the Holy Spirit is the answer to the problems that the world is facing, from homosexuality to chaos to economic depression. Every problem, every single problem, the Holy Spirit has come as the solution. He is the most important person. There is no need to have a United Nations General Assembly when you have not welcomed the Holy Spirit. I wonder what these men are doing. I wonder what the nations are doing. But who will tell them when nobody talks about it? You see, the Church of Jesus Christ is the institution, is the agency through which the Holy Spirit wants to bring the awareness of Jesus and the reign of Jesus on earth. Jesus is born King of Kings. He is the King of Kings. He has a government plan. He has a government plan. He has a plan, a government plan that has the well-being, justice, and righteousness established for the peoples of the world. How dare you feel man can rule himself? How dare you feel with all the greed and avarice and self? And selfishness, man can rule himself and justice will prevail. How? The United Nations General Assembly, leaders of this world, listen to me, listen to this man talking. Jesus is given for the rulership of the world. And until you settle for this, until you submit to this, until you open the doors and let the King of Glory come in. You see, this world is coming to be judged. This world is coming to pass away. Everything that has been failing will continue to fail until you turn back to Jesus. There is need to turn back to Jesus. There is need to receive Jesus in the power that he brought, in the real context of his coming. We are not receiving him as just another religious head, somebody that is talking about the ideals of Christianity or the identity of being a Christian. What we are talking about is the global reign of Jesus. "For unto us a child is born, for unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulders." The responsibility for the governance of the nations is Jesus's. Jesus has the sole responsibility. Jesus died for the world, and Jesus gave his spirit to solve what? The problems that the disciples asked him right here in the Bible. If you must be free from the oppression of the devil, if you must be free from ignorance, if you must have a world that is free of self and fear, if you must have a world that is free of economic depression, if you must have a world that is free of social bankruptcy and moral deprivacy, if you must have a world that is free of religion and the extremities of religion, if you must have a world that is free, submit to Jesus. Leaders of this world, submit to Jesus. In Jesus is all we need to enjoy our lives and give a legacy to the next generation. In Jesus. in Jesus. It's in Jesus. There is a new world coming. There is a new system coming. There's a system under the reign of Jesus, the King of Kings, is just beckoning. Will you just allow the Holy Spirit introduce us into this new order? Will you allow us to establish the order of heaven here on earth? I'm posing these questions to whoever cares to listen. Jesus wants to reign, and he gave his Holy Spirit so that he can reign first in our hearts. Yes, his throne must be established in our hearts first of all, and then the governance of the world is taken care of. My name is Odion Ipuga, meditating again for Destiny Incorporated. I'm asking that God blesses you and God empowers us to leave room for the Holy Spirit, to so that the Holy Spirit can establish in us the reign of Jesus and bring the world, the larger world out there, under the reign of our sovereign King of Glory, Jesus Christ of Nazareth. God bless you. I pray peace on the world. I pray justice and righteousness enthroned in the nations of the world. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Amen.